Hey guys, Trent here with the Rogue Outdoorsman channel. Thanks for tuning in to this week's video. We've got some special footage for you this week. Many of you guys have been reaching out to me and calling, texting, finding out when this video is going to be posted. Before I show you some of the footage, I want to do a little bit of backstory. For some of you, this is your first time to the channel. It's mainly a shed hunting channel. We do a lot of hunting and fishing videos. So if this is your first time here and you love what you see here, make sure you subscribe to the channel either during the video or at the end of the video with the links. A little bit of backstory on this bull. So last year in June, I was shed hunting and came up on this ridge and bumped 7 bulls off of a ridge. They ran down across to the other side, and 4 out of the 7 were at least 380 plus bulls. And one of them, I remember, had non-typical points on the back end, some extra kickers. I remember calling my friend Josh and said, dude, I just bumped 7 bulls, 4 of them are huge, and one of them's got to be 400 already, and this was middle of June. So I thought, man, this has got to be a damn good spot for a camera. So within the next week or two, I hiked back in there and put a pretty cheap, low-level quality stealth cam in there that only took pictures. Started taking pictures from end of June all the way into almost the end of February of the next year, of this year, 2020. So this bull, according to last year's pictures, only stays here during the summer. This bull rubbed his velvet off about mid-August last year, and I think the last picture I have of him is August 18th, white-horned, and then he disappeared and never came back. Now this camera took pictures all the way through February, and this bull disappeared during the rut and never came back, at least up till February, right before shed season. I hiked back in. I was able to go check this camera in April, the end of April, and then I reset this camera with a new cam 4K video camera in, I think, mid-June or early June. On the way down to check, to go reset this camera, I bumped this bull and saw him with the binos, and he was even bigger this year than last year. So I was excited to get this camera set up, get some video footage of them, and have some high-class 4K video footage. Anyways, about a month later, I hiked in, checked the camera, and that was the first time I actually had video proof that this bull was back and that he was bigger than ever. He lost 2 little tiny kicker points on his back end. He lost like his 7th or 8th point on the right side, and he lost a little kicker on the left side. But he grew triple brows this year. He did not have the triples last year. Just the 3rd on his left side is 25 inches long. Well, so a little bit moving forward on this story, my friend Dallas and his dad Doug, we have 2 early season archery tags in this unit. And my wife also drew a late rifle bull tag in this unit. So being that this bull is typically only in this area during the summer, there's a slight chance we might be able to turn him up either during the rut, maybe, or during the late hunt. We have a lead on where he goes. He usually moves about 10 miles from this spot. So my wife might also possibly have a chance at him during the late rifle hunt. Well, about a couple of weeks later, a friend of mine called me and said, hey man, I've got a tip from a pretty reliable source that A3 is camped out on that bull and that they're gonna shoot him August 15th, opening morning of the Arizona governor's tag, which was on a Saturday. And he said, man, if I were you, I would hike in. If you guys want any chance at this bull at all, you need to scare this bull off and push him off. And I says, you know what, that actually would work, because this bull typically shreds his velvet about mid-August and then leaves within a couple of days later. So that's about the right timing. One of the problems with that scenario is that the Arizona governor's tag, if any of you know, is a 365-day, 1-year tag. So even what good would it do for me to push this bull off 1 or 2 days, screw up their hunt, piss everybody off, and they have a full year to turn this bull up somewhere else? So taking emotions out of it and putting logic into it, what good does it honestly do me to chase this bull off? Yes, we would love the opportunity to kill this bull. It would be a bull of a lifetime. So I went in there Friday not knowing what was going to happen. I told my wife I was either going to make some new friends or I was going to make some new lifelong enemies, depending on what played out. Well, Friday after work, I got a late start. My plan was to be up there early Friday, and I didn't make it up there. I didn't pull into the road until about 7 o'clock in the evening, right before the sun was setting. At this point in time, it was just hearsay. We didn't know for a fact if A3 was going to be here or not. When I first pulled in around the first corner, there's a big, huge camp there. And if you've ever seen a guide camp, this is a guide camp of all guide camps. Spring bar tents everywhere, bunch of trucks. And I thought, okay, there's definitely something going on. Now, at this point in time, I had heard that A3 sometimes blocks roads, cuts off access points, doesn't let people into certain areas when they're going to kill a certain animal. And so my emotions and my, I don't want to call it anger, but I was hyped up about what potential situation I might run into. So I ended up driving down the road, pulled all the way into my campsite, and didn't see another person, a single soul all the way. I thought, oh, okay, this is kind of weird. So I set up my bed, made dinner, went to bed about 8 o'clock, and about an hour and a half later, a white Tundra rolled up to my campsite, and Ryan Carter with DC Outfitters pulled up to my camp. So he came up, said, Trent, you here? Says, hey, can I talk to you, man? Says, sure, come on over. So he came in. I was there sleeping on my cot with my canvas cutter, and we had a discussion. He basically just said, hey, man, he says, I don't know if you know, but we're here with the Arizona governor's tag. I've got JJ, the guy that started Jimmy John's here. He has an Arizona governor's tag, and he's going to shoot this bull tomorrow morning. He says, Trent, we put this bull to bed. We know right where he is. And he says, we've got a high, high possibility of shooting this bull tomorrow morning. I says, man, it's funny. I says, I heard rumor that this might go down. I said, it's not confirmed until just now. And he says, Trent, we know you have a camera down there. We'd really like it if you wouldn't hike in there and screw the situation up for us. So I kind of told him my thoughts on it, what the scenarios running in my mind, you know, the possibilities of us turning this bull up later. And it's really one of two things. I could push this bull off, piss a bunch of people off, and they're going to turn him up later anyways. Or the reverse scenario where he said, Trent, you can join us tomorrow, come and film the hunt. We'll even give you a replica set of antlers off of this bull. And I said, all right, I'll do that. And so I met those guys the next morning about 4:30 on the next ridge over. And this footage is what you see from there. I tried to record as much as I could. Obviously a different scenario. I've never been in one of these high governor tag type situations before. Here's the footage.
right here. You see this plastic? Something underneath the back of the gun right here. Give me this peg. Underneath the back of the gun right here. Point it this way. That's going to be my shoulder and the back of the gun. Okay, middle of his body, lower third.
Yeah, right in the shoulder.
You got him right in the shoulder. He's going down, buddy.
He's down.
Go.
You guys got him? Watching him?
Yep, we got him.
Can I have another bullet, Willie?
Yep.
Just in case?
He's down the trees.
I got him.
Wrong shotgun.
Yeah, you got him.
No shot.
Don't shoot. He's fucked.
He's hurt.
You guys think I hurt him?
Oh yeah. You hit him in the shoulder.
That shot was a hell of a shot. Willie?
Lower third, middle body. That was perfect, JJ.
That was a perfect shot.
Just let him be. We don't want to hit that antler.
He's sick, so you got him, buddy.
You guys think he's sick?
Oh, yeah.
I see him. He was rocking earlier.
You want to take a second look, or do you want to stay in position?
I need to stay right here and you block the sun.
Yeah, let's stay right
here. Just in case.
Yep, I'm right here.
I hit him.
He's walking to you guys again.
He's in the thick stuff. Can just see his antlers.
You can't see him now, JJ.
No shot.
Both just get on the black tree.
He's there.
He's about to go down.
Yeah. Okay, you find him, JJ. He's walking downhill. He kind of fell down.
He's down.
He's rolling.
Yeah, rolling. Stay on him.
He's on the ground. He's on the ground. I got him right here. Coming up.
Yeah. Hey, man.
He's still moving. He's trying to get up.
That's so awesome.
That was fun as shit. Wasn't that fun?
I give it JJ some shade. I'll come look at this.
I like that song, man. That's the gods giving the energy.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, you copy.
He still left his head up.
Guys,
he's going to do it.
He's sick.
That was not easy, dude.
How do you do?
Good, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks a lot.
Hell of a bull.
Is he in there?
Yeah, he's right there. Laying down.
Can you believe it?
I do now.
You can't believe it. I love when shit comes together.
Cross Canyon? 960?
Really? 960.
960.
The only gun for it was that Gunworks.
That was money.
That was money. Oh,
yeah. That was a show.
Yep.
I did already.
He's got, look how massive he is all the way up till his fourth.
Oh, he's so much more massive than we thought.
Look at the mass. Trina, have you ever seen so much mass down there?
Nope. That's why I was talking to Ryan about him. Like, depending on how you measure, those are huge. His beam is longer than I thought.
Yeah,
yes, for sure.
It's very deceiving.
He is not smaller than we thought. Copy. Oh my gosh. Dude, look at that. How long is that? 24?
Yep.
You guys may need a helicopter. Bring Jimmy out of here after his heart attack.
Yeah.
Legit freaking giant. Golly, dude.
Look at this.
I can't touch anywhere there's a mass measurement.
Yeah.
That's, everything's over 9 inches. Holy crap.
Yeah, and see, I was giving him eights, and that was at 420.
Dude, he's going to be 40 inches of mass on this side.
Yep.
Un-freaking believable. Oh, my gosh.
I was trying to be super conservative when I was counting.
Well, yeah. You don't want to say 440. Yeah. 440, I was like, oh, I can't say that number. He's there. He's over that.
Yeah.
That is just unreal. Oh, my gosh.
How should we... Problem. We're gonna.
Oh. Nice catch.
That thing's
dude,
awesome.
Put your hand around that base for Trent to get some perspective.
I know, none of this stuff stays,
that, dude.
Does it?
That is unfreaking believable,
yeah.
Right there.
I'm stretching.
Yeah, you got little hands too, but dude, there's nowhere on his beam I could even touch my fingers. Not even close. Holy shit.
Irma Gary. Holy crap.
Faces on that thing.
That's gnarly. Woo! Atta boy, Jimmy John. Ow!
Get down from there.
I'll start the video at
425.
Hey, those main beams are not 44 there, Carter from Utah.
It's 447.
448.
Holy
shit. They hired Matt.
53 on each beam.
Nice.
Hey, let me go.
Can't even fit it in the frame.
Well, that's what we come for.
Yeah. Oh,
that is what we come for.
Oh.
No, they're good.
Weems hit the nail on the head. No, I'd probably come down here if he wasn't that big.
Weems, did you hit 40 on the mass?
Yeah.
It's good. We didn't do it all. We just did a couple.
And what's his inside?
Hayden. Hayden.
Okay. Dude, he's going to be wider than you think.
Yeah.
46?
45.
You guys are unbelievable, man. Talk about it.
Everything's bigger, Ryan.
We got the whole
Everything's
village here.
Oh.
That's
JJ,
right.
Unbelievable.
Come check this out.
Can I carry you?
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, the last 50 feet, the last 7 minutes.
He's got all his tips, all his pearls. That's not 2.5, that's freaking 4.
Hold you.
I keep telling my wife this is amazing.
Didn't you pull out his
holy fingers? Shit. Get up here, buddy.
His face is good, so dumb.
Look at this. Look at
nothing,
this.
Nothing moves.
I never seen him like in my life. It's just how many.
Same.
That's probably for all of us.
Grab that gun.
That's at least 380.
He's closer to 480 than 380.
Holy cow. Man, I'll tell you what, I so appreciate all you guys living with this bull for 15 days.
Dad, his faces are so sweet.
Set it down at
the top. Oh, my dinosaur.
Is that how wide?
I don't even know what to say.
Oh.
It's just awesome.
Hey.
Awesome. He is awesome. 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 Holy
Ryan, look at that
shit.
The third on his left.
No, we missed that by 5 inches. We did. Oh my gosh.
So where the hell did we shoot him from?
All the way up there.
Up there.
What, was it right there to here?
Yeah.
Here. All the way up.
I can't get all that. Yeah.
That's crazy. We got all our drug mules out of the way. Way.
That's going to take that last one out, though.
So what? I don't care.
You have to be there.
No, we don't
care.
It doesn't even.
I don't give a shit.
Look at this. You can't get your hands around. Look at that.
Let me sit on the other end of that thing.
Freak.
Freak.
Freaky fast. Freaky bull.
I'll tell you what, that's a lot of extra cheese right there.
Look at the mass on the back.
Wow.
Doesn't get any better, buddy.
Oh, oh my
that
god.
That is the bull of the woods. The bull.
Where's the lip ball? Where's the lip ball?
I should have brought my lip ball.
You can use one of mine.
Woo! I cannot believe that.
He carried it all the way, didn't he?
The mass is everywhere.
Everywhere.
That's his hand.
Never.
No.
Oh my god. What just happened?
He wasn't even when he almost fell off the mule.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, how do we want to set him up? One of the most amazing photos.
Well, the
of all time.
Before you set him up, who's ever videoing it? Was somebody videoing it? You're videoing it. So, yeah, just so I'm not a hunter. I go with hunters, and I made a lot of dough, and which turned into a lot of dough. And I'm really not a hunter, but I go with great hunters, and they're the ones that get me to be able to do this stuff. And so I'm really grateful for my guys' experiences in a bull like this. I'm just grateful and appreciative. It's one of the most amazing bulls I've ever seen. But the people that I get to be with to do this stuff, Willie, then Ryan, and all you guys from Arizona to do this for me, I'm just touched and appreciative. I want you guys all to know that. I know this is your world and this is, but I just appreciate all you guys for your hard work and the skills that you guys have to do what you do, because you're as good as what you do as what I am at what I do. We're all good at what we do, but I certainly can't do this. I'm not sure if you guys can make a sandwich or not. Anyway, I'm just incredibly appreciative, Ryan, Willie, and A3, and then and all the kids and team, and thank you all very much. And
thank you.
Set them up however you want to take whatever
thank
pictures
you
want.
Thank you.
You
thank
want.
You.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Never been. Good shooting.
How about that gun works, huh? I talked to him on the phone yesterday. Just dial it in and shoot. Don't think about the distance. That's what I did.
Unbelievable.
That was 9 yards.
Bull of a lifetime, man.
Oh,
my
gosh.
It was never going to... It was the only way to... There's no way you could have got this bull.
Yeah, and with time ticking and ticking, you know, we never knew when he's just gonna, he's gone.
Look at our rock hill. We had no shot. That was our only go.
Is that what we just came down?
Yeah.
We shot from way up there from that tree line up on top.
Yeah, hiked all the way up and came all the way down this.
That's great.
It's unbelievable. Well, guys, man, you take as many pictures as you want.
Well, let's get them set up with you, bud, and because
they're down here.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks to all of us. This is a team effort. Pizza sucks without cheese. You know, you got to have a team, right?
You want a ride?
What'd you say?
465.
No wonder he has money and we don't.
471 and 2 8.
471 and 5 8.
That's good, right?
It's all right. Right?
Who's highest?
What the?
Nice job, man.
Hey,
well, I'm clearly
471 and 5 8. You mean you both did 465 and 4 8?
Really?
You guys good as any reservation.
I'm all right with that.
Who did 465 and 4?
You both did.
I did 465.
JJ won the freaking.
No, he did.
So Fisher pulled it.
Fisher pulled it.
No, you stop.
What'd you say?
465
and a half. I price is right, bitched his ass.
Are you getting signals?
Yeah.
Yeah, it starts normal.
Dude, I'll make a payment toward it at the end of the day, Dean. I'll give you 10. I'll give you half of it.
What? Winning.
Right?
Seriously?
That's crazy.
Well, you have an
like, that's a number you can't hear them say.
That's not even with fuzz on it.
Yeah.
It would have been 490 with the fuzz.
God.
Chad said 480.
I've never seen that. I never would have said that.
I was too drunk.
Oh, my God.
471?
Chad.
Yeah.
471.
I've never been off 50 inches.
And five.
Oh, hit the...
What'd you think? 440?
I told you 428.
I was off.
Did you really think that?
I was hoping high 30s.
That left horn is 215.
That's insane.
Each horn was 10 inches bigger than we even thought. Mm-hmm. 10 to 12.
Mm-hmm. 471? Like, that don't even sound right.
I know it don't. But it is.
Not with your hands.
But it is.
That's as tight as you can score. 445
net. That was no bullshit. You saw it.
With a cable? He does it with a cable.
I'm just saying. Yeah. He's a freak.
He's a freak. He nets almost my score.
Hey, thanks for watching this week's video, guys. If you're new to the channel and haven't subscribed, you can hit this icon right here and be subscribed to the channel. If you missed our previous 2 weeks' videos, you can click over in the corners over here, catch up on those videos. As always, guys, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to share this with your friends and family, and we'll catch you guys on the flip side.